Hello students, my name is Shyam Sunil. I am going to design a photovoltaic systems for you in this semester. Okay, so design of photovoltaic systems is one subject that is very useful for you if you are going to perform any project or research based on our solar power generation. Okay, so this subject will give you basic knowledge about PV cells and connection of PV power generator with utility grid. And so many techniques used for generation of power using PV solar. Okay, so now in this video we are going to see what are the important topics in each and every unit. Okay, we will be having 5 units, so we are going to see what are the important topics we are going to cover in this semester. Okay, so first unit is the PV cell series and parallel connection. Okay, so for the first unit is PV cell and series and parallel connection. This unit deals with basic PV cell structure, and we are going to configure it and we are going to model it. Okay, so the first lecture will be based on PV cell and its model. Okay, and the second will be short circuit, open circuit and peak power parameters, cell efficiency, fill factor. So these are the parameters of our PV cell. And next important topic is we are going to connect them in series, and next we are going to connect them in parallel. The first last one is we are going to see how the IV characteristics of our PV cell are behaving. Okay, so this is regarding first unit. So first unit is just basics of PV cell and interconnection of PV cells in series or parallel. So we already know that. So we are going to connect the cells in series to increase the voltage rating. We are going to connect the cells in parallel to increase the current rating. You already know that. Okay, so this is about first unit. Now let us move to second unit. So second unit is mainly focused on incident of energy estimation and PV system sizing. Okay, so incident of energy system means, so in our PV solar power generation we are going to convert the sunlight into electrical energy. So we are going to measure how much amount of sunlight is giving such amount of power. So this is what we are going to see in the second unit. Okay, so there are basic terminology you are going to learn here: insolation, irradiance. Okay, so these are important topics regarding sunlight. Okay, so we are going to see how they are related to our electrical power generation. Okay, and the next important topic is sizing of PV for applications without any batteries. Okay, we are going to see how can we implement our PV cells in such a way that we are going to make them applicable to so many applications. Okay, so this is about incident of energy estimation and sizing of PV. We are going to learn about sun radiation, sunlight, and we are going to see how we are going to size the PVs. Okay, so this is about second unit. And in third unit, MPPT algorithms and PV battery interfaces. So this is one of the most important topics in this curriculum actually. Okay, so MPPT stands for maximum power point tracking algorithms. So we know that electrical energy is being produced from sunlight here. Okay, so how can we get maximum amount of electrical energy for such certain amount of sunlight? So that is what maximum power point tracking methods. So there will be several methods to give maximum power output from a PV solar panel. Okay, so those we are going to learn here. Okay, and then we are going to learn about PV battery interfaces. Okay, so there are two methods for MPPT actually. One is hill climbing method mentioned here, another is incremental conductance method. Okay, so those are things we are going to learn in the third unit. Fourth is mainly focusing on cooling and water pumping applications. So how can we cool? So there are Peltier device, and we are going to learn about this. Okay, and we are going to learn about thermal aspects, water pumping principles, centrifugal pumps, reciprocating pumps, PV power, pumped hydro application. So these are the things we are going to learn in the fourth unit. So fourth unit is mainly focused on cooling. Okay, and coming to the final unit, that is most important actually, because we are going to interconnect our PV solar generation with our utility grid. Okay, so this entire use of all four units above will be applicable here. Okay, that means the 4 units we have learned so far will be very useful in the fifth unit. We are going to interconnect the PV solar power generator with the utility grid here. Okay, so what are the problems you are going to face? So all these all the concepts in the fifth unit are very important. Okay, so that's why I didn't highlight anyone. Actually all these are very important. Okay, all the concepts in the fifth unit are very, very important. Okay, so we are going to see how the grid connection is going to be happening, what are the problems we are going to face if we interface photovoltaics to grid. We have to convert them into stationary models like DQ controlled grid parameters.
We are going to convert AC to DC, then DC to AC. We are going to see complete three-phase grid connection, single-phase DQ control DQ grid connection. Okay, and we are going to see pulse width modulation, how it is helping our interconnection of solar power with grid. Okay, so these are the things we are going to learn in this subject. Okay, so the main focus is power generation using solar energy. Okay, so we will be learning about PV cell basic structure, its model, how can we model a PV cell into its physical parameters like resistors, voltage sources, inductors. Okay, so that we are going to see in the first unit. And second unit consists of sunlight insolation, irradiance, sunlight energy estimation. And next one is sizing of PV is important in second unit. Okay, so third unit is MPPT algorithms, battery interfaces. Fourth unit is mainly focused on cooling techniques. And fifth unit is very important, that is interconnection of our photovoltaic power generator with the utility grid using different methods, configurations. So we will be facing so many problems if we are going to interface our PV solar with the grid. Okay, so as we have to keep the voltage, phase and frequency of the supply to be constant and fixed, that should be supplied to grid, we will be facing synchronization problems. So how are we going to overcome them? So that is discussed in the fifth unit. Okay, so this is about introduction to our syllabus here. Okay, so very soon we are going to start the classes. Okay, so I hope you have basic idea now. Okay, thank you.